are. We're back, and I'm telling you what a great trip today. You know, one of the places we're looking to go to today is Quito Paquito, and that is a watering hole that has been in this area for thousands of years. Now, this natural watering hole is a spring that has been here, you know, forever, that natives, Spaniards of all different, Spaniards use this watering hole. All the ancients use this watering hole. And there are things in that watering hole that are unique to this one location in the entire world. This is the National Park Service. No food or pets. No food or pets we have. Take a look in here and see.
Quito Paquito.
Very nice.
And go up the other way. There's a couple of roads that come up off of that road that, along the border that go to old copper mines. One of the dry little ways that
there. Tell you what a nice place we have in here. How cool is this? Really a neat place. You know, a lot of times you're on your way to Rocky Point and you just don't stop because you're ready to get to the ocean. But the reality of it is how cool is this? Well, in Xplore years, I'm gonna say I'm about 6 feet. So I'm 65 years old. If I was a cactus, but I'd have a hell of a time carrying this camera because I wouldn't have an arm. This road is unbelievable.
Look at the cactus.
They're everywhere. Look at that valley down there. Oh my gosh. That is unreal. This is like being on a drone, but with no drone. Kind of nice little cool change in the hole. We come to this valley. Look out. You know, something about walking out here in the desert. You know, this road, one thing about the road is, you know, definitely two-wheel drive. We haven't been anywhere where you've needed to be even high clearance. You know, a lot of people don't know that. Now, we came across one person on a UTV, but that's really been about it. So we've had this whole road to ourselves. And this area is just, I mean, it's pristine. If you look out there and you see how beautiful that is, Organ Pipe Cactus. So, this is the only place in the United States that Organ Pipe Cactus grow naturally. Now, I didn't know that. That's pretty incredible. Now, most of them get to be 15 feet tall, and they live up to 150 years. It's pretty incredible to think that these things have been growing out here, and this is the only place in the United States that these cactus grow naturally. Wow, that's pretty incredible. They actually have fruit also. So they actually flourish in the desert here. Look at this view. Isn't that spectacular? You know, we've seen, this is about the third one of these we've seen. So if you do get out here and get into trouble, there's also a camera on here as well. And pretty much tells you in three different languages, if you need help, push the red button. Rescue personnel will arrive shortly to help you. Do not leave. There's one of the shafts of the Golden Bell Mine right there, covered up. Looks pretty damn deep. Can't tell how far, but definitely looks deep. Looky there. How cool is that? So we're at Bonita Wells right now. We're gonna go through this old corral. Wow. Look at that. How cool is that? I can't get over those aerometers or aeromotors that, you know, that were made in Chicago, and you see them all over the West. And so how cool is this that you come through here and see this? Imagine being a cowboy out here. You would definitely be on your own, and you would definitely, oh, look at that. Look at that fence right there. It's kind of look like railroad ties. I don't know if they are or not, though, but look at that. Ain't nothing getting through that. And then that cowboy technology. One thing, if you've done any time on ranches up here, and we've got one, and you look at these, the old cowboys, boy, they had to make the best of what they had. And they truly worked extremely difficult on, you know, just whatever you had, the baling wire together, as they say. But I tell you what, this is beautiful. Beautiful area. Look at this. This old corral is something else. It's a bathroom. There's a picnic area here. Tell you what, this is a really a well taken care of place considering. I mean, you are in the absolute middle of nowhere. Here's the border right here. So we're right here on the border as we speak. Now there's Highway 2 over there and in Mexico. So where we're at right now is Quito Baquito. Now, Quito Baquito has been a watering spot for the Spanish, for Quino, when Quino came through here and natives and pretty much everybody through here used this location. Now, a lot of birders come down here now. It's a big birding spot. So what you're going to find is there's some special things in Quito Baquito that make this place unique other than you're right on the border of Mexico.
They used to have a big tree over there. It's dead and gone. This is it. Pretty exciting.
Now, if you were anywhere in the Midwest and you looked out along this and you said, oh, look, basically a duck pond, right? There's thousands of duck ponds in every county in the Midwest, but the reality of it is you're not in the Midwest. You're a half a block from Mexico in the middle of the Sonoran Desert. And this water hole is a very, very special place. Quito Baquito, which basically is a pond that is fed by a spring, which is a really an incredible place because there are species here that you won't find anywhere else in the world. Yeah, I said the world. There are pupfish here. There are miniature snails the size of pepper flex. My gosh, that's some mini escargot for those untrained. So this place is really incredible. So what you see is, most of the time what you see, like those couple over there, they're birding. This is a world famous birding area. Now with the amount of traffic and how late it is, we're not gonna see a lot of birds right now, but if you were here in the morning, you would see all kinds of wildlife throughout this area. And you know, the natives also came through here, the Spanish came through here. So basically what you find is, this is definitely another oasis in the middle of the desert. And definitely a stop if you were coming across to go to the Gila Bend or head to Yuma or go on the Devil's Highway. You would have came through here on Mexico, and this definitely would have been one of your stops. So the amount of people that have been here, that have been in this area, is absolutely unbelievable that this small pond that doesn't look super special is one of the most important areas and all of the Sonoran Desert. So one of the most important things is this was a place that everybody coming from Mexico City through to Gila Bend or to Yuma or on the Road of the Devil would stop here, because this was a main area to get ready or prepared to be able to come up and get the water you needed to get through the long Devil's Highway that you were going to take as you went up, as you passed through this Sonoran Desert. This is absolutely a fabulous place. It is incredible, and I tell you what, it's one of the most special locations in the Sonoran Desert, is this spot that looks like a normal duck pond that you would see in the Midwest. But the reality of it is, this was the lifeblood of the desert. You know, another thing that's in here is for this little small habitat in the middle of absolutely nowhere, there are certain species in here that are endangered. There is a mud turtle that's in here that you can see. It's going to be difficult. I can't get it underwater for you. I'll try over here. But they're on the endangered species list. So there's all kinds of little different creatures and animals that are on the endangered species list. And there he is right there. And I don't think you're going to be able to see him underwater, but I'll try to get you close. I saw a couple other over there, but and probably the coolest name of anything. Sounds like also almost a meal from Taco Bell. Give me a couple of those paquitos, right? Paquitos, something like that. Unbelievable. This place is awesome. Beautiful that is. Now we're on the Ajo Mountain Loop right now, which is I believe about 21 miles. So we're taking that loop. So that'll mean that we have crossed over all the way around from both sides of the road. And I tell you what, the desert is just, I mean, it's just spectacular here. Again, this is the most beautiful desert anywhere that I've ever seen anywhere in the world. And you're only about 2 hours out of Phoenix. So if you come into Phoenix, you're only about 2 hours. We're right on the border of Lukeville and Snoida. And so it's still a nice day trip. You can do all this in a day. Tell you what, this is the craziest road I think I've been. I can't believe we're on a paved road in the middle of absolutely nowhere. This is like crazy. Man, I've never seen anything like this. How incredible is this? Makes you just want to get out and start hiking. Man, how beautiful is that? Look at that. Let's just take a minute just to kind of take a look. Wow, how gorgeous is that? And I can't get over the fact they paved this. So you came in and all the lower area was gravel, but still an excellent gravel road. And then when you came up in these hills, you know, it must have been that they just had so much trouble trying to maintain the roads that they just said, well, what the heck? Let's just pave them. What a natural beauty. Look at this. I tell you what, what a great, great day loop. I mean, you can loop all this. You get up early. You could come and you could do the west side, and you could come over then do the east side. What a great day this would be. And in another couple weeks, if you can get a chance to be out here when all the flowers are blooming, what a great place this is going to be. It's going to be just a gorgeous, gorgeous area. It's beautiful today.
We're going back.
Yeah, we're going back. We're heading back.
That's about right.
So this is a canyon, and again, here we've got closer than we were before to the arch. And so what I'm gonna do is take a walk over here and see what they call this and see exactly what this is and what it's about. And Wow, how beautiful is this look right up here? Now that is the trail too that you can hike up there, which is really pretty cool. So let's look at this sign here and see if it will tell us anything that we need to know about that beautiful arch. There's one on the top and there's one right there. How incredible is this? So here it is. This is Arch Canyon Trail. Easy to moderate, which isn't bad. 1.2 miles, 30 to 1 hour. That's not anything, really. Wow. What a cool place. So you come back around the arch right here, here through that valley, and then you get your uphills right here, and it puts you right up on that arch. How cool is that? On another day, you know, this one we're going to have to come down and do. We're going to have to come down here and do this. That's definitely going to be on the list. I'll tell you what, this is just a beautiful place. Again, if you want to come do this, you can't beat this. This is just awesome. What is this orange stuff? I have not seen that. Look how beautiful that is. Wow. Look at down that valley. This is definitely a lost world that, you know, a lot of people know about it because we've seen a lot of vehicles. But I've never even knew that. I've drove by this 1,000 times. That might be the name of the new book. Places I drove by 1,000 times and never knew existed. This is crazy. This is here. And I've been to Rocky Point 100 times and never seen anything like this. Here we are, we're back, and I'm telling you what a great trip today. I'm telling you, we made the loop that would be on the west side, we made the loop that's on the east side, and the east side was absolutely stunning. Now the west side was absolutely great as well, but I'm telling you what, if you want to take a day trip out of Phoenix, this would be a place that you would definitely want to put on your calendar and schedule it in, because I tell you what, this whole loops were absolutely unbelievable. And the backside, as you'll see in the video, was just stunning. So, man, make sure that you get down here because this is really a gem that I've driven by. I know going to Rocky Point 100 times and never even knew it existed. So make sure that you get down here. Now, if you like this content, please subscribe, please rate. And please hit that notification bell. It shows that you care. Jay Shrek, Black Flag Expedition on the trail.